the success that we had.
So when you made when you first made a lot of money in the NFL, was there a splurge purchase that you made? Was there anything where you were like, you know what, I'm gonna buy a $500 pair of sneakers, or I'm gonna buy an $80,000 sports car? Like, was there a splurge moment? Like, maybe it was something small. Maybe it was like, a lady won the lottery who lived near me, and her splurge, it's not too crazy, but she got every single member of her family, and every one of them got a shopping cart at Walmart, which sounds like low end, right?
But that's dope.
These are low income people, and it's like, no, every kid gets a shopping cart. Fill it up. Do whatever you want. Toys, video games, go hog wild. Like, you know, like 25 members of a family.
Money orders. That would be what I would do.
Fill up a shopping cart with money orders.
Yeah. She won $5 billion.
All five will fit in that cart.
Oh. She's going to be owing me some.
Ironically, man, I was never that guy. So, I know it sounds super lame, but I really wasn't. The only thing that I did splurge on was like this shit that you see in here. So I got these Focal speakers, like this mic, this piano back here is a Motif. So I did things like to fulfill me. So it wasn't necessarily a splurge. Like I hate cars. I'm like, I'm not a car guy. I've had the same car since I got in the league. Still, I don't buy cars. I wish I didn't have to have a car.
What car is it?
So 2000, so when I went undrafted, I had to have some kind of vehicle. So my business manager flew down, and I didn't know how to rent a vehicle. I didn't know how to rent an apartment. I was wet behind the ears. And so we got me a 2007 or 6 Dodge Charger. And so I drove that until 2011. In 2011, I got a truck we leased it. We didn't lease it. It was an exchange. So I did autograph signings for that dealership, and they gave me a truck. They didn't give it to me, but they let me lease it. So I had that for 2 years. And afterwards, my guy was like, hey, man, you need to buy a car. I was like, I don't need to do shit. And so I held on for that as long as I could. But then I had two kids, and I was like, all right, man, let me be an adult. So yeah. I bought a car, and I wanted something dependable and nice. And so I did. I bought a Range Rover. It was like 80 grand.
You wanted dependable, so you went Range Rover.
But it's the funny thing, though. It wasn't
really dependable.
So I got a G Wagon. Got kids in the back, you know?
But it's the truth, though. So it's like, I wanted something that I didn't have to, like, go buy. Like, I wanted something I didn't have to buy, like, or fix in the long run. So, like, I still have the same car today, right? It was in 2012. Yeah. I've had a car for it. Really is, though. It has been great. I haven't done a lot. It's good on, because you need a car with good shocks in Houston, because of the potholes here are crazy because it rains so much. Yeah. And so you need something with good shocks. So I didn't want something I had to keep bringing
in. Houston. Are you still in Houston?
I live in Houston.
I was mentioning that crazy like shooting pigs from a helicopter thing earlier. That's where I did it, was in Houston. Dude, we were we were in the neighborhood where a lot of the Texans lived, they told us, shooting in a truck with suppressed silenced machine guns, shooting the pigs out of their yards.
Right.
Yeah.
They one of my one of my physical trainers that used to work at Houston, they hit me. And they asked me if I wanted to go hunting. This was like 2 weeks ago, actually. And they said, we're going to like shoot some pigs out of a helicopter. And yeah. I was like, I was super on the fence about that shit. I was like, I had my kids that weekend, so I couldn't go. But I was definitely hesitant, man.
Dude, it's the most fun you'll ever have. They take
that shit, man.
If you've ever seen a Vietnam movie where, like, you know, they're flying over those rice paddy fields and it's just like that.
Is that what you're pretending you're doing?
Oh, absolutely.
Going down so like, the Viet Cong.
Yeah.
So mentally, like, what's going through your head while you're offing these pigs? Like, what's going through your head?
Try to get a high score. Get as many as I can. You know, it's like how can I most efficiently massacre all of them?
It's
so much fun.
Well, like, but these aren't just—you're not just killing them for the fuck of it. Like, these are absolutely things that are destroying crops, ruining farmers' livelihoods.
That's absolutely true.
Yeah,
it's so gruesome that the helicopter company shows you a 30-minute video about how evil pigs are before they take you up in the air.
Pig propaganda, huh?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Yeah, it's pig propaganda.
They absolutely show you a pig propaganda film, and then you go up in a helicopter with a, you know, whatever armament you want. Like they don't care what you take up there. There's no law. Like, the law in Texas allows you to do just anything you want. You can use explosives. You can use machine guns. You can use anything you want to kill them. And it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun.
I couldn't imagine doing that.
The pilots are so damn good. Like, they'll put you really low, like right on the pick, and he can fly that helicopter sideways. So you're sitting in the passenger seat right next to him, like just like in a car. And so he'll fly the thing sideways with your seat, you know, advancing it forward at the exact same speed as the pigs are. So you're just looking down at them. They're like 50 feet below you, and you've got like a semi-automatic AR-15 or a machine gun, an AK-47, whatever you want to take, shotgun, and just really destroying them.
So is it so easy that it doesn't feel sporting?
Absolutely, yes.
Oh, so that's why they show you the propaganda video about like how the pigs, you know, run banks or whatever they try to get.
Yeah, this is not hunting. They control the gold. This is shooting. Yeah, yeah, absolutely. There's no sport involved. You're in a helicopter, right? Like, it's not like you're like all camouflaged up with like deer scent on, like hiding in a bush somewhere with binoculars.
I like how it is so violent that like this firm or company or whatever literally had to hire like a Goebbels version for pigs to like convince you to hate them before you go down.
Exactly. Absolutely. So what do you do with do you eat it afterward or just fuck it?
You leave them out in the field to rot.
Oh yeah. My God, bro.
They said there's enough coyotes there that the coyotes will clean the bones up within a day or two, and the farmers don't mind because they're doing so much agricultural damage, and the homeowners don't mind because like a week before we got there on one of our trips, they had went into some of the football players' yards that had like really nice sod yards, and they had done like $35,000 worth of damage to one guy's yard because they like put their noses and like root the grass all up looking for food, and they had just destroyed this guy's yard. So everybody there was just like,
so they deserve to die.
Oh yeah, yeah, they definitely deserve to die. Yep. Yeah.
And the big winner in this are those coyotes.
Yeah, I guess so. True. And people until like Aaron us comes that are by like
kicks their ass,
riding around with night vision and shit. Yeah, that was fun.
Dude, you had night vision goggles, bro.
Yeah, yeah, night vision goggles. Just like
that's
like,
even
like
less fair. Pigs can't see at night, right?
Not very well. Not very well.
Standing there just.
You should. You haven't seen that video that we made called the with my cousin. Like, he's got Apache helicopter night vision goggles on. He's got like the helmet on and the goggles that like come down like Call of Duty and lock down in front of your eyes. And his machine gun has an infrared laser on it that you can only see if you have those night vision goggles. And you know, it's not very sporting at all. It's shooting. It's yeah, a real good time.
It's like hunting at the zoo.
It's exactly like that. I mean, we got out and fought that one with a knife that time. We there was a little bit of sport to it.